Yo, what is up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to another video. Today, I have a story for you guys. For those of you that are new to the channel, I have told stories on here for probably 4 years, something like that. I have plenty of them, and usually they are, in my opinion, the best videos I've made. They seem to be enjoyed the most. A lot of my friends mention them all the time, actually. And I think it's a great way to put the story into video format so that I won't forget it later, and that was the whole purpose in making them. But in my 19 years, there's only so many crazy fucking stories that could happen to me. If you haven't watched the other videos though, I'd highly recommend it. They're a lot of fun. But today I'm gonna tell you guys about a road trip. With saying that, in my 2 years of adulthood, I have taken two separate road trips. Both of them were fucking awful, like really bad, poorly planned, everything, teenage boy shit, that's all it was. But with that being said, also, there's two separate groups of people that have probably flocked to this video, one of which is from a road trip that I will talk about in another story video. I thought I'd just do this in chronological order. So with this road trip, I had just graduated high school. And this was right after, this was like right after Corona, I'm pretty sure, like the big virus hit. But everything was still open. I don't know. I guess I kind of get my timelines confused. I don't know when everything started to reopen for the first time or whatever. But the gist of it is, one of my buddies had just gotten a new car, like a really nice car. And one of the like stipulations on his contract that he signed or some shit had something to do with needing like X amount of miles before a certain date. So the idea was, with this road trip, was that we were gonna take this car, go on a road trip, put a fuck ton of miles on it so that he could hit the mileage by the deadline. And that's kind of how everything came about. And we had just graduated, and one of my buddies had sent me a graduation gift from his family, and it meant a lot. And that particular friend had moved away. He lives about 4 hours away from where I live. So I had this big brain idea that I was going to go surprise him in his new city, which is like way smaller than ours, but that's besides the point. We were gonna go surprise him, and I thought it was the best idea I had ever come up with. It really wasn't. It was fucking awful. But the day came, or whatever, again, horribly planned, by the way. We had nothing planned out. But it was going to be me and three of my friends. The day of the trip, my buddy with the car backed out. He said that he couldn't. So originally, I was just like, okay, then we're just gonna bag it. Like, our car is gone. I had just got a car myself, but it's not that nice, and I didn't know if I could really trust it to go that far. So I said, fuck it, me and my two friends. Got in my car. We went, got it emissions tested. Spent like $50 on snacks, and I also bought a charging cable and proceeded to buy the wrong fucking one because I'm just stupid. I'm really dumb. Like, really, really dumb. So, we got back in the car after the emissions test, and we were shooting onto the interstate, and maybe it was a sign of things to come because I almost crashed before I even made it onto the interstate. I'm also, mind you, a shitty fucking driver. Beyond awful, so probably my fault, who knows. But it was a straight shot for 4 hours for the most part. My buddy, he was sitting in the front seat with me, and he had Google Maps up. So after like 3 hours, I think it was, he goes, dude, there's a turnoff up here that says it's like 20 minutes quicker. I was like, okay, let's do that. That's a good idea. Yeah, let's take a detour. That's fucking sick. Otherwise, it would have been just a straight shot of the interstate, but my dumbass said, let's get there quicker. Nothing could go wrong. So we turn off, and it shoots us onto this road that is literally just, it was like 40 straight minutes of just fields. And I don't know if any of you have seen The Children of the Corn, or like, what's the other movie? Jeepers Creepers. It looked straight out of those two movies. It was no fun at all. Not a fun time. Fucking sucked. But then we start winding up this road, and it gets to a point where we look to the side of us, and it says, from this point forward, you lose cell service. I was like, oh, fuck, that's sick. That's so good. Yeah, if we get fucked up here, we are screwed. And from there, it was like this windy-ass, 90-degree turn-ass road all the way up a side of a mountain. And once it cut out cell service, it did not give you an inkling of, like road signs telling you how many miles till you were out of this thing. There was no idea to tell how long this road went on for. It was just winding all the way up a side of a mountain, and it literally went on for like an hour and a half, and none of us had signal, nothing on the radio, pure static. We ran into a couple like little ass like towns that were just fucking weird, like old rundown towns, one of those like towns that I wonder like how did somebody actually live here. But there were people, but it took us like an hour and a half, but it was literally the longest hour and a half of my fucking life. It took absolutely ages. Eventually, we ended, and we got to our destination, which was sick. I had saved my buddy's address, because I said, hey, we're gonna send a graduation gift back, can I have your address? So, another big brain move by me, because I'm so fucking smart. And then we get into the town, we find his address, there's nobody home, of course there isn't, why would there be, why would anything go right? So we're like, okay, fuck, let's go to his work then, and we go to his work. Mind you, my buddy works at Sonic, there's two separate Sonics in the town, so we go to one, of course we go to the wrong one, and eventually I'm like, fuck it, we're screwed, like, no surprise, whatever. So I call up my buddy. Mind you, he doesn't pick up for like half an hour, and when he does pick up, he's like, hey, what do you want? Sorry, I've been working. And we're like, surprise, we are here, we are in your fucking town. And it was nice, he was extremely excited, but it didn't help that he was still working for another 3 fucking hours. Again, sick idea from me, I am really big brain. And so, me and my other two buddies had to just basically wait for like 3 hours. And mind you, there wasn't much to do because it was in the middle of a fucking pandemic, like right at the beginning. So, I mean, turns out there wasn't shit to do in that town anyways. But after he got off work, we went back to his house or whatever. We had a lot of fun, actually. It was a good time, genuinely. Played some 2K, did whatever. And I looked at him, and I remember going, in a small-ass town like this, like, what do you guys do for fun? Like, there's no mall, you know, there's not much to do in the way of shopping or anything like that. Obviously, I could not see the excitement in this place. It was just like an old mining town. And he proceeds to tell us the story of the bridge. Apparently, the bridge was, it's not even a bridge, it's literally a gate. It's a fucking fence. Like a chain link fence that has been placed horizontally over a hole. So it's just this horizontal chain link fence with like chicken wire over like a 50-foot drop. And apparently the story goes that somebody had fallen down there and died or whatever, so they put this fence down horizontally with chicken wire or whatever and secured it so nobody else would fall. Obviously probably just an urban legend, something like that. But this was their idea of fun. They would go to the fence, like, every weekend, gather on it, and jump. Just jump. I don't know why. I mean, we went to the fence, because what else were we gonna do? I went onto the fence, and it was weird. It was weird, I'll give it that. Like, you look down, and it's just a 50-foot drop at your feet, and your feet are just, like, almost large enough to fall through the chain-link fence, but not quite. Apparently people just jump, and that is their idea of fun on a fucking weekend. They go to the bridge, or it's literally just a horizontal fence that they call a bridge, and they jump. That is it. So we ended up staying, like, way longer than we should have, because it did not go smoothly at all, and we also left late because my buddy who canceled, so we ended up staying for probably about 4 or 5 hours hanging out with them. Definitely, probably not worth the drive, honestly, but, you know, whatever. And then, we had to leave because my other two buddies had to be at work at 6 in the morning. So, we left probably about 1 a.m., like, mind you. Again, big brain shit. We are so fucking smart for cutting it that close. And so, we zipped out of there. Realistically, I wish we could have stayed the night and just worried about it in the morning, but they had to be at work. So, we got out of there. We stopped at a gas station, filled our tank. I got hella caffeine, like an ungodly amount of caffeine, like 4 or 5 hour energies, which should be about 20 hours of energy. So I was going to be all right, obviously. We pull out of there, and as we're leaving, like probably 30 minutes in, we turn off on this road. And mind you, it's pitch black outside. It scared the fucking shit out of me. It was just this entire field covered in these giant fucking statues. I don't know why. It was just a field of random misplaced statues on both sides. Probably about 100 of them. Probably shouldn't have scared me, but I was tired and it was dark. So my guess is that they take all the statues from around the state that aren't being used or need recommissioned and take them there. But it was just this giant field of fucking statues. We kept going. At one point, the interstate became just too... We made sure to get on the interstate because I was not about to take that winding-ass fucking mountain road. Again, in the middle of the fucking night, I could not be asked. But we hop back on the interstate, and at one point, it's just two lanes. I'm pretty sure one of them wasn't... I'm pretty sure it was one lane and one was a path. No, it was two lanes. But there was an 18-wheeler in front of me. And at this point, it's probably 2:30, 3 in the morning. And this 18-wheeler is just going from one lane to the other for literally like 20 minutes. It was fucking weird. I'm just like going, mind you, like 10 miles under the speed limit because that's how slow this fucking 18-wheeler was going. And it's just swerving from lane to lane. I was like, this is fucking great. Eventually, like, it stabilized in one lane, and I was like, fuck it. And I got over to the other lane and just gunned it past this fucking thing. It was not a very fun drive. I almost fell asleep at one point. Not good. I definitely nodded off for a second, but we made it safely. I shot that thing like 100, not, well, I was probably going about 100 the whole way home. I really wanted to get home. And mind you, my car is not built to go 100 miles per hour, but we shot that thing. Like, we got home probably about 4:35-ish. I feel bad for my buddies who had to work the next day, but I went home and crashed until like 2 p.m., so it was fine. But definitely far from the smoothest trip in the world, in large part because I am god-awful at planning and come up with literally the worst ideas known to man. I do hope you guys enjoyed. Like I said, there's another road trip story that is undoubtedly more wild than this one. It's just chronologically, telling this one first makes more sense. So I will get to that one at some point soon. I do hope you guys enjoyed, and I will talk to you guys later.